happy, excited? I mean, what do you feel after getting in a nomination like that?
Yeah, really excited. I guess you don't really think about it too much, and to come into the club on Monday and get told, yeah, I was really excited, and yeah, I'm really honoured.
Has it been a long time coming this season? You've had some pretty good games.
Yeah, I guess you don't really think about it too much, but yeah, I just wanted to play consistent footy, and I guess yeah, it's a good reward of that.
Well, it talks about Pet winning the award, but just late charge for that from you.
Yeah, hopefully. No, I don't think so. I think Peps is, you know, up there with the top three, and yeah, he could have a late charge home.
Have you surprised yourself, Dan? I mean, you always back your ability in, but you've come in round one debut, been pretty seamless, and oh, you missed a couple here and there, but you must be really wrapped with how you've gone.
Yeah, obviously, from where I've come, I've surprised myself, and I think keep surprising myself on some of the stuff that I've been working on, and for it to show up, in my edits and on game day and stuff. Yeah, it's surprising, and it's good to see that some of the hard work's paying off.
What's it like when you do review a game and you have a pretty good performance against Collingwood? Does it just really give you the confidence to know that all the stuff you are doing is really working?
Pause. Yeah, it's a confidence. Oh.
Pause there. Yeah, I thought you were just
going to
pause my mic. And take two.
What would I say? are you confident that the hard work, when you see a result, it sort of reaffirms that it's all going in the right direction?
Yeah, it's really confidence builder when you see yourself doing it in the game that you can do it, and it's just about doing it for four quarters almost every game and making it consistent in your game, which is probably the hardest part.
And the prospect of playing finals, I think you played 14 games this season, but how much does that drive you now and the excitement levels, build for that?
Yeah, I think I just want to get some confidence in the last, two games of the season and put myself, put my best foot forward going into finals and, just get some really good confidence.
How's that battle for spots in the back line beast? At the start of the year, we all sort of looked at it and went, well, there's the back line right there, and it's pretty hard to make any changes, but you've sort of throwing a spanner in the works yourself and a few others. How's the competition back there?
Yeah, it's obviously very competitive. We've got some good names, and I think it's been really good for the team that we've had people in the SA NFL play really good footy, and Ken's rewarding good form. Puts a lot of pressure on the AFL team and obviously making us play better as a group.
What's Ken been asking of you from your game each week?
Yeah, he just wants me to be really consistent and really tough in the contest. I know that I need to bring that every week to stay in the team.
But your weapon, though, that's your foot skills, isn't it?
Yeah, my foot skills and my reading of the play, but obviously being tough in the contest is the backbone of my game.
And efficiency is pretty handy too, Dan.
Yeah, it is. It's good when you can trust yourself to hit some some risky targets, but I guess that's probably one of the reasons why I am in the team.
What have you learnt the most this year, mate? What's the one thing that stuck out, or a couple of things that you've gone, okay, something I've got to get across?
Yeah, I think it's just AFL footy generally. You make two mistakes a game and you're out of the team, stuff like that, and just making sure you're switched on and you've got to improve every aspect of your game and have a really whole game to stay in the team and the pressure. So I guess, there's a lot to take out of this year, but it's been really good.
That sounds pretty cutthroat, two mistakes. What impact does that have on players? You can't go into a game thinking, if I make an error, I'm out. So how do you sort of deal with that?
I think you've just got to build the confidence at training and just rely on yourself. Being a young player, it probably happens, a bit more because you're inconsistent, but you've just got to trust yourself.
And tell us about the Doggies this week. How significant a challenge playing at Ballarat, probably ground you haven't seen much of before.
Yeah, we've got two games left before finals, and I think it's just building confidence. We've sort of dropped off in a bit of contested footy the last couple of games, so it'll be really important for us to get that up and give us some confidence going into the final series.
Have you played at Ballarat?
Yeah, I've played a couple of games in TAC, and it's not too different to today, so very windy and rainy, and I'm sure we'll see a few more blokes in long jumpers this weekend.
What about the couple of returning injured boys in the back line along with you? How did Brody and Hompshire go out there today?
Yeah, I think Brody will be assessed this week. He's had that ankle injury. I think he might have been rushed back a week early, so they'll be very cautious on him. But yeah, he's every chance to play. And
Hompshire?
Yeah, Hompshire's similar boat, yep.
Who's influenced you the most this year, mate?
I've worked pretty close with Matthew Broadbent. We have similar assets and similar growth areas. So he's been really good in helping me in that term. And then obviously when I played in the sample, Jacob Surgeons really helped me, and Nathan Bassett as well.
You have slightly more growth areas than Brody.
Yeah, a few more growth areas up top, which is good.
How is it working with Brody? I mean, you two, you almost fight for the same position some weeks.
Yeah, and I guess that's the best part. He's trying to help me get better, and I'm trying to help him get better by, playing good footy. So I guess that's only better for the team, and it's really good competition down back at the moment.
Come up against the Bulldogs team, they just had the announcement that Bobby Murphy's going to retire and is a legend of that club. Do you think that, does that present a bit of a danger for you guys with the team that, number one, wants to shore up the final spot, and number two, wants to do the right thing by a club legend?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, there's a lot of that sort of stuff going on, but we can only control what we can do every week, and we want to bring our style of footy, our contested ball, and move the ball really well and really fast. So we'll be trying to do that.